Well, it is my pleasure to introduce our 2021 salutatorian. The whole time she's been here at our school, she's never failed to set her standards high and strive with the best of her ability to reach them. As much as she worked hard on her schoolwork, she also served others with grace and humility. Please help me welcome Viannca Sinocruz.
Thank you, Mrs. Miller, for the lovely introduction. Good evening, parents, teachers, family and friends, my fellow graduates, and Dr. P. It is an honor to be standing here as salutatorian of the class of 2021. I am grateful and proud to be part of a group that has stayed strong together during these challenging times. Let's not remember 2021 as the year of COVID. Let's remember it as the year that we beat COVID. I was curious of the Salutatorian Award and looked it up. Here are some interesting facts. Michelle Obama was a salutatorian from Whitney Young High School in Illinois in 1981. Other salutatorians include President John F. Kennedy, Albert Einstein, and singer John Legend. I'm glad to say that I'm in good company. To give some background, I was the youngest of the five cousins who attended Grace Christian School. Next to my sister, Viannca Sinocruz, Daryl Francia, Gracie Lee, and Gavin Lee. All of them already moved on to high school. I was a bit terrified to be left alone, but I knew that I could count on my classmates to be there for me. Being the youngest doesn't mean that things get easier, but it does have its perks. For one, I get to observe my older peers to better prepare for what's ahead and to avoid any pitfalls along the way. Even until now, I'm not a stranger to be the youngest of a group. As a 13-year-old, I am part of my 16's volleyball club. I may not be the captain or the MVP of the team, that'll likely be my sister, but it certainly pushed me to play at a higher level. I would like to give a shout out to the GCS volleyball team. It didn't happen this year, but for the past two seasons, I was part of the GCS volleyball team who played for the championships. Let's go, Roadrunners! One thing that made a profound impact on my junior high journey was becoming the president of the National Junior Honor Society last year. It changed my life and it brought new meaning about being responsible and making a difference to the community. It opened my eyes to charity, volunteer work, and what it means to be active. To my NJHS clubmates and to the graduating class, let's remain committed to serving our community. I'm excited about the future. I'm not sure what I want to do, but this recent pandemic has inspired me to consider studying medicine. I've heard stories of faith, determination, and perseverance, despite the difficult odds. I realize that heroes can come from anywhere, and there is a saying, if you cannot do great things, do small things in a great way. I would like to thank my parents and my sister for always believing in me and teaching me the value of hard work. In behalf of the class of 2021, we are also very blessed to have such wonderful teachers, Mrs. Nerigian, Ms. Gasser, Mrs. Miller, Mr. Gazelli, Mrs. Garner, Mrs. Cheney, Mrs. Clark, Mrs. Rafer, Ms. Cashman, Coach Fulmer, Mr. J, and Dr. P. Thank you so much for your tireless efforts, unwavering support, and constant encouragement. You have made us who we are today. We are blessed to be taught of Christian values and to be given the tools that we can use to build the foundation of our future. In Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker, Luke told Rey, 1,000 generations live in you now, but this is your fight. Well, let's not make this a fight. Let's make this a mission, to give back to the community and to serve as a Christian example for others to follow. I want to close with my favorite expression from Senora Garner. You are loved. Go be awesome somewhere else. To the graduating class of 2021, te deseo buena salud y felicidad. Or, I wish you good health and happiness. Thank you, and God bless.
Viannca back up. Viannca! I ever so carefully carried the very pretty medal you get with me and had it right here and then completely forgot to give it to you. So this is your Salutatorian medal.
Good evening. I'm here to honor the person for the award of service. This is just a special person, but not only that, but it's so dear to my heart since I have NJ Jess and I have so many wonderful kids that put so many hours to helping other people in at our school and in our community. And I'm just proud of all the NJHS kids and all their help. And any time that I've asked them to paint with Mrs. Temple this week or help with Roadrunner Race this week with the little kids, and I just have to say I'm just really proud of all of you guys because you guys just go far and beyond. And I'm really proud of this group. I really am. Okay, that was nothing that I wrote on my piece of paper, but all of a sudden I just came up here, and it's just so dear to my heart just to see that everybody just has a heart of giving, and not all kids do, or not all people do, and it just blesses me, and you bless so many other people, and I just love it. Okay, back to what I wrote down. I just can't say enough about this one person. I have seen the growth for the past 3 years, not only educationally, but as a leader in giving their time to others. This person is one of the members of the NJHS Junior Honor Society. She has not only led our organization, gosh, I wasn't gonna cry, as our president last year, but has spent an abundance of hours serving our school and our community. Just in the past year, she has shared the kindness by giving her time to others, and most of her time was spent babysitting her cousins, teaching multiplication, the photosynthesis process, and punctuation rules. Viannca Sinocruz has given 57 hours of serving others just in this last year. I can't say enough of Viannca just listening to her speech today and where we were last year. I've just really seen the growth, and I just appreciate everything that you've done. So congratulations, honey.
Viannca Sinocruz. Berlin Stonis.
To last throughout the years.